Hey, this story is just one part of the Stories with Sapphire podcast. If you want to hear the full episode in its intended context, the link is in the description below. It's story time. Chapter 1, The Luna Moth, submitted by Amanda. My husband and I own a large home, and we decided 7 years ago to section off the basement and rent it out as a large two-bedroom apartment. We ended up with the best tenant anyone could ever ask for. Her name was Karen, and she quickly became like family to us. She was Dutch, and she would call my husband and me her adopted Dutch children, as she was always feeding us Dutch food. We loved it. She came to every holiday get-together with us, and she never missed a birthday party. Karen was widowed prior to moving in with us, and she never had any children of her own. In June of 2020, we had gotten a message from Karen's family member that they were having trouble getting a hold of her. They asked my husband and I to go into her apartment and check on her. That is, unfortunately, when we discovered our best friend forever sleeping. She had passed away in her bed, and it was determined that she passed in her sleep from coronary artery disease. We had to let her family know so that we could make arrangements and gather her belongings. This was one of the hardest times of all our lives, as Karen was loved so deeply by us all. One evening, when her brother and sister-in-law were here collecting some of Karen's stuff, we decided to sit by the fire and have some drinks, cry, and reminisce about one of the loveliest people to grace this earth. Suddenly, out of nowhere, a giant, bright green moth fluttered past all of us and almost landed in the fire. This moth had to be 7 to 8 inches long. We all commented on how it looked like a fairy because it was so big. My husband and Karen's brother are avid outdoorsmen, and not one of them had ever seen this type of moth before. We all started saying that it was Karen, sending us a sign that she was with us. The moth flew around the fire again, then landed on Karen's apartment door that looked out to the fire pit where we were. It then flew around and landed on each person's chest. At this point, I was very intrigued and needed to know what this was. A quick Google search determined that it was a Luna moth. It is rare to see a Luna moth because they don't have long life expectancy as adults. I read my Google findings aloud. Luna moths signify new beginnings as they represent a continuing quest for truth and knowledge, the gift of intuition, psychic perception, and heightened awareness. Things that are associated with seeing the light. They can also represent the spirit itself. So we were all pretty excited to learn that and thought for sure it was a sign from our friend, Karen. 2 days later, I got a text message from Karen's brother. He said, "You're not going to believe this, but there is a giant Luna moth graffitied on the side of the funeral home where we had Karen cremated." He sent me a photo, and I couldn't believe my eyes. He was right. It was amazing, a giant mural of a Luna moth. What are the odds? This confirmed to all of us that she was with us that night, letting us know she was okay, and letting us know her spirit was still with us. Attached are photos of the Luna moth we saw that night, the graffitied Luna moth on the funeral home, and the tattoo I got in memory of her. Thank you for sharing this story on your podcast. Due to COVID, our friend Karen still has yet to even have a funeral, and it bothers me daily that her life on this earth hasn't gotten recognition or closure or anything. I feel like I want the world to know just how amazing she was and the impact she made while she was here. So maybe this is one way of doing that. So again, thank you so much. Thank you for joining me today. If you like what you heard and would like to support this independently run show, consider becoming a member of my Patreon. Visit patreon.com/storieswithsapphire to see the different tiers and perks. If you'd like to submit a story, email me at storieswithsapphire@gmail.com. Selamat and good night.